Learning to use AI tools like ChatGPT can make you more productive at your job. But learning to build AI tools like ChatGPT will make sure that you have a job to be productive at. Will AI take over your job? Well, I don't know about that. But one thing I do know is that building AI tools would be one of the last jobs AI can replace. So if you want to be future-proof, you might want to invest some time into learning to build AI. And if that's not a good enough reason for you, you'll be shocked to know that OpenAI, the company behind ChatGPT, pays almost $1 million to its AI engineers. In this video, I'll give you a step-by-step guide on everything you need to learn to be able to create AI tools like ChatGPT. This video is especially important for someone who already knows some programming or math and wants to transition into an AI-related job. Let's do this. Human intelligence comes from the transmission of information through neurons. Neurons are nothing but a bunch of interconnected nodes in our brain. In the same way, artificial intelligence also comes from a network of interconnected nodes called artificial neurons. And these networks are called artificial neural networks or simply neural networks. To be able to build AI tools like ChatGPT, we need to learn how to build these neural networks. But to get there, we'll have to take many smaller steps. You see, neural networks are part of this field called deep learning. In deep learning, we take a neural network, train it by showing a lot of data, and use the trained network to predict something. What to predict can vary depending on the task you assigned to the network when you trained it. In ChatGPT, the network is actually predicting the next word of a sentence. I know that this might not make sense right now, but stay with me till the end and I'll explain it in more detail. Moving on. Deep learning is a subset of this field called machine learning in which machines acquire the ability to learn. In other words, deep learning is not the only way a machine can learn to predict. There are many other ways to do that, and all of them combined are part of machine learning. To be able to learn deep learning and neural networks, we need to master machine learning first. But how do we do that? Well, machine learning has three pillars: mathematics, statistics, and programming. Let's tackle them one by one. Let's start with mathematics because you'll need a good knowledge of math to learn statistics. Linear algebra, calculus, and probability theory sit at the core of machine learning. And most of us have been burnt by them either in high school or college. But the good news is that you need these concepts only to know how different machine learning algorithms work. But once you have learned that, you just write programs that implement all that math for you. So I don't believe you have to be a math genius to be able to do machine learning. To learn math for machine learning, I recommend this specialization called Mathematics for Machine Learning and Data Science on Coursera. This course is created by deeplearning.ai, which was founded by Dr. Andrew Ng, who's arguably the most well-known professor of machine learning. Later in this video, we'll go back to Professor Ng when we want to study machine learning. Anyway, this specialization has three courses, one for linear algebra, another for calculus, and last one for probability. If you think all of this is too overwhelming for you, you can also check out this Data Science Math Skills by Duke University. This course is not as comprehensive as my other recommendation. If you're someone who doesn't want to get too involved with the math behind machine learning, or already knows the math and just wants to brush up, this course is for you. Now that you know math, let's move on to statistics. Now, statistics is a very vast field and requires many years to fully understand. But luckily for us, we don't need to know everything for machine learning. For statistics, we'll use breadth-first search for learning. We'll learn some basic core concepts and then build upon them as we encounter new machine learning algorithms. To learn all the key concepts that you actually need, I recommend this course called Introduction to Statistics by Stanford University. This course covers all the important ideas like probability distribution, center limit theorem, confidence intervals, and regression, etc. By the end of this course, you will know all the statistics that you need to get started with machine learning. Before we can finally do some machine learning, we need to learn programming. To be more specific, we need to learn programming in Python because it's the most popular choice when it comes to machine learning. Now there is some talk in the town about this new programming language called Mojo, which is compatible with Python and is 35,000 times faster. But it's still too early to predict the future of Mojo. So we are going to stick with time-tested Python for now. For the purpose of machine learning, we don't need advanced level programming skills. If you know the basics like if-else statements, functions, and classes, etc., you should be able to pick up machine learning easily. So we are not going to build any crazy projects with Python at this step and would focus on basics. But we will build some machine learning projects using Python at a later step in this video. To learn these basics, simply go to learnpython.org and do some hands-on exercises. exercises. Finally, we have reached a place where we can start doing some machine learning. We are just one step away from learning to build tools like ChatGPT now. For machine learning, we need to go back to Professor Andrew Eng. Check out this machine learning specialization on Coursera. This specialization is divided into three courses. One for supervised learning algorithms like linear and logistic regression. Another one for unsupervised learning algorithms like k-means for clustering. And the last one for advanced algorithms that also introduces neural networks. If you really want to have a deep understanding of machine learning, this is the best course out there. The course is free for the most part. The only caveat I would like to mention here is that the code samples and the Jupyter notebooks that actually let you play with the code are not available in the free version. Once you are done with the course, head over to Kaggle and do some hands-on practice. On Kaggle, you can see the projects that other people have built. You can follow along with these projects in the beginning to build some confidence. Once you are comfortable, you can participate in one of their competitions. This will help you in two ways. One, it will give you confidence that you can complete machine learning projects independently. Two, it will help you build a portfolio of projects that you can write in your resume. Now that you're confident about your machine learning skills, let's go back to our original goal, which was to build AI tools like ChatGPT using neural networks and deep learning. Machine learning specialization by Dr. Eng already gives you an introduction to neural networks, but it's not comprehensive enough for you to be able to understand advanced AI systems like ChatGPT. For that, you will have to build your skills in deep learning. But there's no need to worry because Professor Andrew Eng also offers a specialization in deep learning. First three courses in the specialization cover the basics, which is how to train and test neural networks. In the fourth course, you will learn convolutional neural networks, which is basically computer vision. In computer vision, you'll learn how to train machines to recognize patterns in images, which has applications in autonomous driving and face recognition. But if your main goal is to understand how ChatGPT works, that's part of natural language processing, which is the last course in the specialization. This course covers transformer architecture, which is what ChatGPT uses. By the end of this specialization, you will know all you need to start a career in AI. I know that this path might seem very long for many people, but that's the cost you pay to work on the next generation technology. Another path that is very closely related to machine learning is that of data science. In data science as well, you use data to develop insights, but you don't have to be an expert in machine learning. If you want to know the fastest way to learn data science, watch this video. My name is Sahil, and I'll see you in the next one.